Hi, it's Spike with Rotochopper Customer Service. In today's video, we're going to be going over the RotoLink monitoring system. RotoLink allows users to access key performance indicators from a smartphone, home computer, or tablet. In today's video, we'll be showing you actual screen footage of the RotoLink operation. Now let's get started. Once you've received the email from Rotochopper Service, you can open the link and type in your username and password, and this will allow you to get into the RotoLink startup page. Once you get to the home page, double click on the asset you wish to monitor. The maintenance life tab will show the life remaining on each of the listed items. The bar will turn red when the life is below 20%. If you hover your mouse over the bar, it will show the actual amount of each remaining life. Select the Overview tab to see the time, date, stamp of each of the maintenance items. Notice you'll have the time, date, and also the engine hours related to those resets on the control, on the maintenance life page. Select the Vibration and Bearing Temp tab to see the rotor vibration and bearing temperatures. Vibration readings are selected at the beginning of the day and stored. Hover the mouse over the top of the markers to see exact values. The vibration is also taken on a daily sample. Any values greater than 20% will show in red. Any temperature values greater than 180 degrees will show in red. Select the engine data tab to see the engine performance data. The data can be adjusted by adjusting your date. The graph will automatically update the last 7 days. Values of engine usage, percent of load, fuel usage, and engine run hours can be selected and viewed by simply hovering the mouse over the bar graph to see what the different values are. Select the production data tab to view grind hours, feed hours, rotor hours, engine idle hours, and engine run hours. Again, the data can be changed by simply clicking a different date on the calendar, and it will show the last 7 days. Select the Performance Report tab to see and produce a performance report. A date adjustment can be done on the right-hand side of the page. Simply select your start date, and you can select an end date, and the report will automatically fill it in. We can see machine hours, machine vibration, grinding hours, bearing temperatures, all in a weekly report. Select the Alarm tab to view the past trips along with date timestamp. The default setting will be for the last 7 days. User can adjust this time frame by simply selecting the calendar and adjusting the date. Time date stamps are on the right-hand side. Actual trips are on the left-hand side. Select the History tab to view engine data history. The graph will show the last 7 days. This can be adjusted by clicking the 7 days, 14 days, or 30 days. To zoom into a section of the graph, you just simply highlight the area and it will zoom to it. If you wish to zoom back, you simply click Zoom Out. Notice you can also add and remove pins on the right-hand side. If we do not want to see the pressures or the temperatures, we can simply unclick them. Click on the graph and it will automatically update. Select the Notification tab to set up notification rules. The machine will email or text message the users listed in the Notification Rules section. To edit a rule, double click, and then you'll have to assign an asset to the asset included rule in order to make them part of the rules. You can select which fault you want to be sent to which users. You can select the time frame, how often the warning is sent,
and also SMS or a text message can be sent along with the email. Simply enter email addresses in the email CC box or phone numbers in the phone number box. Click Submit when completed.
Select the Go Live link to connect directly to the controller. If you're logged in, you will notice that you will have selections already there. But if you have not logged in lately, you will have to enter a password and username in order to get into the live link. Select the Link Manager Mobile. It will show all the assets you are able to view. Select any asset. Select the RotoLink view. And select the www. We are now linked to the machine. And I can change the screens from here. Notice the screen is locked. The only way a user can change any settings on the controller from the RotoLink is if the operator presses the Allow Access button. Notice on the engine page, there is the Allow Access button. But I can view all the settings in here, but I cannot change any settings until the operator has pressed Allow Access, as long as it says screen locked.
So here's an example of how we can use RotoLink data history to view fuel pressure. On the graph, we have 30 days of data, which can get very complicated, but I can see here there's an anomaly. So I can zoom in, see that the fuel pressure has dropped very low. If I zoom back, I can remove pins and some of the data to see more clearly what's going on. Normal operating fuel pressure should be 90 to 100 PSI, and here we can see the fuel pressure has been good, but as we get further on down the graph here, we have lost fuel pressure. The operator simply replaced the fuel filters. Fuel pressure came back up to 100 PSI, and everything was operating as normal. Again, if I wish to zoom in, I can highlight an area on the graph, and the graph will automatically update to show me exactly what the data points were. The data is loaded every 5 minutes into RotoLink, and the data samples are every minute.
We can also track bearing temperatures. Each daily sample, each one of these graphs is showing the daily run of the bearing temperatures. We can see the difference between the drive side and the idle side bearings. If we have any kind of anomaly or it doesn't look quite right, we can zoom right into that graph and see exactly what the bearing temperatures are doing. It's taking a bearing sample every minute, and the data is sent to the RotoLink website every 5 minutes. It's updating every 5 minutes.
Once again, it's Spike with Rotochopper Customer Service. Reminding you, a well-maintained machine is a safer, more profitable machine. Thank you for watching, and remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel.